Hello friends, welcome to BSc Agriculture. If you are coming to my channel for the first time, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Your subscription and likes are always motivating us. So let's move to the video. In this video, we are going to see about fundamentals of entomology. I am going to teach you the molting in insects. So molting is said to be a natural process in insects, like where it used to take its body development to another stage. So while seeing the molting, so molting is said to be known as ecdysis. So ecdysis is nothing but a periodical process of shedding the old cuticle, which is accompanied by the formation of new cuticle, is known as the molting or ecdysis. So the cuticular part discarded during molting is known as exuvia. So and also the molting used to takes many times in the insect during the immature stages before attaining their adulthood. So it was said to be based on the insect. The molting usually takes place 5 times or 6 times, even greater than more. And the time interval between the two subsequent molting is called as stadium. And the form assured by the insect in any stadium is known as instar. So these are the keywords we must need to remember. So the first one is ecdysis, which is the shedding process of old cuticle and new cuticle to form, as well as the cuticular part discarded is known as exuvia, as well as the time interval between two molting is known as stadium, as well as the form assumed, wait a minute, form obtained by the insect after any stadium is known as instar. So these are the words we must need to remember. So I have already told you the form as well as stadium. So it's how the process usually to takes place. So after the hatch as well as the born from the adult ones, say they used to grow and used to go for ecdysis state, as well as and after that the second one is used to turn. After that particular instar formation, they used to form an adult stadium. So it was said to be known as a continuous process where the growth used to takes place until it obtain its adult stage in the environment. So while seeing the steps in molting, behavioral changes, the larva used to stops feeding and becomes inactive during its molting process, and there is a change in epidermis. In the epidermis, the size of the cell and its activity, as well as the protein and enzyme level used to be increases, and the cell used to divide meiotically and enlarge in size during the process of molting in any insects. In apolysis, the process pushes the cuticle of the epidermis. So where there is a detachment of old cuticle from the epidermis is said to be done, and the formation of subcuticular space as well as the exuvial space, which is known as chymid's layer. The scientist name is chymid, who used to found the formation of subcuticular layer in the insects. And the secretion of mouth gel in the subcuticular layer, which is said to be rich in cutinase as well as the protease. So under the activation of molting gel is said to be done during this molting process. So the molting gel is said to be converted into molting fluid, which is rich in enzymes, and it activates the endocuticle digestion as well as the absorption of endocuticle by the molting process. And the final process, which is a new epicuticular formation, it's where the cuticular layer is said to be overlaid on the epidermis of the every insect. So the inner epicuticle is deposited between the cuticle and the procuticle formation, where the procuticle is formed below the inner epicuticle, and the waxy layer is formed, which is the wax layer is deposited once before the inner epicuticle is done, just before the ecdysis through pore canals. And the molting, while saying that it used to form the two steps. So the first one is the rupturing of old cuticle. So insect increases its body volume through the intake of air, and which enhances the blood flow to head and thorax, and thereby the old cuticle ruptures along the predominant line of weakness, which is known as ecdysal line. So after that, the removal of old cuticle. So where the periplastic movement of the body and lubrication of the molting fluid helps in the removal of old cuticle. So during each molting, the cuticular covering of the body or leg, as well as the internal lining of foregut, hindgut, and trachea are said to be discarded, so which is known as exuvia. And there is a cement layer formation after those removal of old cuticles. So the dermal glands use it to secrete the cement layer with from the tentocuticles, so just after the ectasis process. So and the tanning and as well as hardening and melanosis occurs after the ectasis process, where the formation of exocuticle is to be done. So the upper layer of the cuticle develops as an exocuticle through the addition of chitin as well as sclerotin, which is known as tanning. So and the formation of endocuticle, the lower layer of the procuticle, which develops into endocuticle through the addition of chitin as well as the proteins arthropodin. So this layer increases in the thickness of the endocuticle in this process. So I have given it as the picture where the gland pores used to open in the first step. After that, the gland pores are said to be closed, and after that, in third one, there is an increase in the number of enzymes which used to disintegrate the old one, and there is a line between the old and new one, so it is to be formed, and the old one is said to be ruptured, which is shown in this sixth picture, and the new one is said to be came out. So sorry, and after that there is a coloration. So the integument segment often shows an extensive color, which is mostly due to the pigmentation in exocuticle, which is also taken in the process. And the color that are brown, black is said to be known as by the melanin, as well as in yellow and red are due to the carotenoids, and the white is due to the petrines of the compound. So the other colors are homochromes or eye pigments, which is retratines, and carmine red in the cochineal, and lac insects with these arthrocyanins are the enzymes which is present during the body wall formation in this molting process. So the control of molting. So the molting process is mainly controlled by the endocrine glands like prothoracic gland, which is secreted the hormone ectocine. So the molting hormone which is used to activate the molting gland to secrete the molting gene, it's how the molting process used to takes place in the insects. So I have given in the picture representation of the controlling of molting. So in the first one is, let's take it as prothoracic gland, so where it used to get the activation from the brain, and it goes for the secrete molting hormones, and it activates the prothoracic tropic hormone produced by neurosecretory cells of the brain. So and it used to the ectocyte is released, and there is a separation between the old one as well as the muscular one, and the new cuticles are said to be formed. And while in expansion of new cuticles, the old cuticles is said to be get ruptured and they're swallowed by the air and the force bloods, and the peristaltic movement out of the old skin used to remove the old one out, and the new cuticular saw is said to be formed in this one. So it's how the total process takes place. So I have given the lecture notes in description. If you have any doubt, please comment in the section, or else you can be able to join us in the Instagram page, and we can be able to clear those ones. So if you like the video, like it and share it with your friends, and subscribe to BSc Agriculture, and hit the bell icon to get regular updates. So thanks for watching the video. Thank you. I'll catch you up in next videos.